Welcome to Arizona Midday, everyone. I'm your host, Destry Jaton. Today on the show, we are focusing on fashion with the five things every woman should have in her closet. Also, ways to avoid the makeup meltdown and look natural beautifully, let me tell you. Plus, free tickets to the water park and offers for back to school you can only get here today. But first, we have some great ideas to satisfy your snack craving in the summer. It seems like the kids and the family are always hungry, right? But a lot of the time, you really don't want to eat a lot and get a full meal because it's hot outside. It just makes you feel, ugh. Well, today, we have tasty and healthy snack ideas for everyone, even the pickiest eaters, from the Sassy Spoon. It's a cookbook with dozens of delicious and easy meals and snacks. Author Jennifer Cola Arakal is here with the recipes. Thanks for coming on today.
Thank you, Destry. Great to be here.
It does seem like in the summer, you just don't want to eat some big, heavy meal. A lot of time you want to have a snack, but you want it to be healthy, right?
That's right. And hopefully it's nothing prepackaged, because that is usually what we think of when we think of quick and convenience. So what I've brought today is a number of ideas that should satisfy everyone, from sweet to crunchy to savory snacks that are both quick, light, won't make you feel very full, but at the same time you're getting a lot of nutrients, and they're all homemade and don't take a lot of time to make.
All right, I like the not taking a lot of time
yes.
part. It starts with just something simple here.
Right, actually I've got a couple of sweet things here. This is just fruit, you know, apple and sweet potatoes, believe it or not, just microwave sweet potato. Slice them, no seasoning, they're very sweet. It's almost like a pumpkin pie taste.
And I hear that these sweet potatoes are like the best thing you can do for your body.
They are so good for you, and they're delicious cold. They taste like candy, seriously.
I never
yes.
have had them cold.
Yes, and now take on top of that, dip that into something, a sweet dip, which what I've got here is, it's made with Greek yogurt, plain non-fat yogurt, which we know how healthy that is, but mm-hmm. it doesn't have a lot of personality by
right.
itself. So I add some nice, wholesome applesauce to it for sweetener, with your favorite spices, which I put cinnamon and nutmeg in. And then the fruit I chose to put in there were some whole cranberries. You know, you don't want to get the can of with all that
right.
high fructose corn syrup in it, but even blueberries would work. But this right
what
there is
idea.
Super sweet. Yes.
And my kids love this look. Like, if you serve them a tray and let them dip stuff,
well,
they love it.
Watch this.
Me too, though.
Okay.
I like it too.
And to make it even more fun, you can take this dip, right? And we can do kind of like a sundae.
Oh, they would like that too.
Right, you can take, and think about maybe some chopped bananas, which kids love.
And, oh, you're making it look really fancy now.
Right, you can go creative with this. So, you know, if they're at home, they can eat it like this. You know, lunch boxes with all the little Tupperwares they have with the nice sealable lids.
Yeah,
this can go in there with a cold pack, right? And the rest can go in little plastic bags.
That's a good idea
yes.
for lunch.
Another really easy transportable sweet snack is basically oatmeal fruit bars, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And all I do is I stir up oats. And however you would make oatmeal, but oats, I put some protein powder in there, some blueberries, some applesauce, things to give it a little bit of flavor, and just bake it in the oven. There's no oils.
I love this for breakfast.
It's very good for breakfast, and it's almost tastes like a cookie bar.
All right,
so,
a cookie bar,
right.
can't go wrong with that. I like that too. And then you have
some crunchy.
Yes. We like that too.
Yeah, so maybe you're watching movies at night, or the kids maybe like to have potato chips or Fritos. You don't need
and that's
potato
like the worst
chips,
thing,
right?
Yeah.
These are pita chips, homemade pita chips,
homemade,
and they are
though.
Delicious. Yes. So I took whole wheat pita chips. And if you just put your olive oil and whatever seasoning you like in something like this with a paintbrush, you can
mm-hmm.
even get a regular paintbrush, and just paint it on the squares and put it in the oven, then you're not dousing it in olive oil or butter or anything like that. Bake it in the oven at 350 for maybe 15 minutes, and it's super crunchy.
What do you put on this? Because this is really good.
That's just a mixed, a variety of no salt dried seasoning. You know, you can go to the grocery store and get a mix that has no salt.
And this is no salt, really.
No salt.
And you don't
nope.
miss it at all. I'm
nope.
serious. Great idea.
Another very delicious, crunchy, and very healthy snack is, believe it or not, what's in here is baked garbanzo beans or chickpeas. Okay, you drain them. And same thing, we're on a cookie sheet now with a little bit of olive oil. When you bake garbanzo
really?
Beans, they get crunchy, not hard, but deliciously savory crunchy.
Mm-hmm.
And then whatever nuts you like. I put some pumpkin seeds in there and a few, I think walnuts are in this batch. And I'll, again, put some seasoning on there. No
Good
salt,
stuff.
But it just gets super flavorful.
All right, great. great idea. And then you have something maybe a little bit more hearty.
Exactly. Two things I've brought here today to show you. One is, this is the finished product of what a roll-up. Now, we've all seen different types of roll-ups at parties, and they usually have cream cheese, things like that in there.
Right.
This is a healthier but very delicious version. What I've done here is cheese, again, because I'm going to be rolling up and refrigerating and want to send it out with the kids when they go to practice or whatever. I want it to stay together, so I actually melted the cheese on here, if you can see it, in the microwave, just so it gets a little soft.
Okay.
And then I put some greens on there, and then you sprinkle some vegetables, roll it up, and there
you
go.
And what kind of vegetables did you put in?
Sun-dried tomatoes, chopped up carrots, and three colored peppers. That's it, and it's very delicious.
And there you go.
And same thing with a quesadilla, sweet potato, red onion. When you think about making a cheese crisp, why just
making
have cheese?
Healthier.
Put something healthy in there.
Well, thanks so much. Yeah. Wonderful ideas today. Again, the book is called The Sassy Spoon. For more information, all you have to do is go to sassyspoon.com. I love these ideas. Great ideas.